Welcome to the second part, where we will be coloring bats. Usually, I am not a huge fan of this animal, but this variety of fruit bats with bright orange fur around the neck is quite adorable. So, when we need to color bat, we need to select pencils for two main areas. One is the wing and the second is fur on the head and on the neck. The wing is basically bones, which are quite visible and relatively light comparing to the skin, which is between the bones. Near the bones, skin folds are slightly darker and central part of each skin fold is slightly lighter. I decided to start from the darkest polychromos color on the wing. I will be using Payne's gray and I will be shading areas of the skin closer to the bones. For the central parts of the wing, I decided to use cold shades of gray. I will be using one lighter and one darker color. But on especially big areas of the skin, I decided to draw additional folds. If we look at reference pictures again, we can clearly see that if wings are folded, they have a lot of skin folds on them. For the fur on the neck and on the head, I decided to use grays again, but here I will be using also warm shade of gray. I will be also using dark brown color. I selected walnut brown. If you look at reference pictures, we can see that darkest parts are nose, very huge eyes, ears, and sometimes some areas of the fur near the nose. Otherwise, all skin is quite pale gray, but with quite long individual hairs. So we will need to color fur on the head and on the neck with quite big pencil strokes to imitate that fur is long and fur basically looks like mix of quite long dark gray and light gray hairs. Especially long fur is on the neck. And there I basically will be using terracotta or sanguine colors from Polychromos set, but in the area where head of the smaller baby butt is closer to the mother's head, I also added shading again using walnut brown. I tried to make fur on the neck especially bright because it's probably the brightest part on the animal and it will be attracting attention to the face of the bud, so it's important to make this part quite visible and like focal point of the composition. I enjoyed coloring bud, the bigger one, the smaller one and those which are on the background. But as usual, my biggest problem was what to do with the background. In the end, you will see that I decided to use the simplest way of doing background. I simply applied soft pastels. I tried to select pink, which will be close to the color of the lily pilly berries. And in this way to make balance between upper and bottom parts of the picture. I also added small moon to show that animals are nocturnal. To color with polychromos was slightly easier comparing to previous picture where I used prismacolors. In the end, I was still quite tired with fighting with this paper. I enjoyed coloring bad, but not so happy with the background. And you know what? I was still so in love with this book and with designs that I immediately started the third page. So very soon you will see the next picture which I selected from the same book.
Thank you. Thank you.